Our Simulation Institute first opened its doors in 2011, and we're an accredited institute by the governing body of the Society of Simulation of Healthcare. We want to reduce medical errors, improve patient safety, and improve communication and teamwork amongst students. By the time they matriculate off-island, they participate in about 8 simulation activities, and we go through about 500 hours of simulation activities every 12 weeks at our Simulation Institute. We have 6 high-fidelity simulation mannequins, and they're SimMan 3G. They have a heartbeat, they have a pulse, they have secretion, so they can do all of those things. And we have 10 simulations rooms. 6 of them are designed to replicate a North American emergency room.
The sim lab is really helpful, the simulation. It's like walking into a hospital. You really get the real feel of it. This is how it's really gonna be. You're not gonna know what to do, but we're gonna give you the exposure now so that when you get to your clinicals, it's not just a free-for-all and you have something to expect from that.
We get to practice hands-on clinical skills to kind of help make the information make more sense.
Each team is made up of 8 students, and those 8 students work with 1 physician, and they discuss a patient case in a clinical encounter. So they receive a patient's chart, and they discuss as a team what they think is going out with the patient outside of the patient's room. The minute they walk in, they're expected to be able to treat a critically ill patient.
Hi, Mr. Cole. My name is Dr. Yadagari. This is a team of doctors. We're here to help you. How are you feeling today? You go ahead and listen to his lungs for me, please. Mr. Cole, I can see you're short of breath. Don't worry, we're gonna take good care of you. Can you come around and get a blood pressure for me?
Mr. Cole?
Let me check his abdomen.
All right, go ahead, check his abdomen.
Let me know if you feel any pain, all right?
Does that hurt at all, Mr. Cole?
Wheezing and strider.
Okay, throughout?
Throughout all the time, please.
All right, go ahead and do a cardiac exam for me while you're there, please.
No tenderness or rigidity in the stomach, and bowel sounds are present.
Okay, great.
Blood pressure is 140 over 90.
All right, how about the heart rate? Will you check the monitor?
Heart rate 132.
Okay, so he's a bit tachycardic. Let's take a look at his arms. Let's see if there's any lesions, any scars.
And after they do that, they discuss the biggest parts about the case: teamwork, communication, and clinically relevant material. Not only do we have these 6 advanced sim mannequins, but we have task trainers. We have the Harvey mannequin, we have Fred the head, and they're each designed to do something different. Harvey's designed to teach heart sounds. Fred the head is designed to teach how to use airway devices. We can improve patient safety and just allow them to think clinically from day one. That's our ultimate goal. We really love when our students can apply what they've learned in simulation to real life examples. And 2 noteworthy examples come to mind. One student was able to save her child's life because of an anaphylaxis case that we ran. She delivered epinephrine and was able to save the life of her child. That's pretty remarkable. The second case is a student helping his mom discuss with her end of life wishes, and that's all because of a simulation that we offer here at Ross University School of Medicine.